Thus, I had a real great relationship with him.
From the front porch of his home in Winston-Salem.
His room's just about like it was.
Nick Nicholson holds on to the last picture taken of his son Tommy before he was killed 22 years ago. He was only 24 years old.
Something you just can't get prepared for.
Now this grieving father waits with other families who lost loved ones to hear if the man who committed the crime should be set free.
In your opinion, should he ever be free?
No, he murdered four people and tried to murder five more. I think there's a real possibility that he could lose it again and hurt somebody.
During his trial, Michael Hayes said he thought he was shooting at demons when he killed four people and wounded five others. Now doctors at Dorothea Dix Mental Hospital are saying he is no longer mentally ill and is ready to be released. For the last few years, Hayes has been leaving the hospital on work release, even has a girlfriend and children. Still, Nicholson isn't buying the diagnosis.
So you don't think he's cured?
No. Like I say, he's the same person that he was in 1988.
He says he doesn't hate Michael Hayes, but won't ever forgive him.
Some things you just don't forgive people for. No, I don't think anybody wants him out there footloose and fancy free, as you might say.
And if Hayes is released this time, Nicholson says there needs to be a responsible agency in charge of monitoring and documenting his whereabouts, that he shouldn't be allowed to just roam the streets just like nothing ever happened. In Winston-Salem, Margaret Johnson, WXII 12 News.